into the older TFT technologies that allow us to have a wider viewing angles and also like more vivid colors. So as I said, the most basic technology for monochrome but also for TFT is a twisted nematic TN displays. And this kind of display, as we already know, have a problem with the grayscale inversion. So on one side we have a higher retardation, and we will not see the image clear. So that's why we have other technologies like VA, which is a vertical alignment technology, where we put the liquid crystal in different organization, and IPS, which is in plane switching, another variation of the TFT technology. And as you see, the VA and IPS, they don't have a problem with the viewing angles. You can see the image clear from all the sides, yes? So it doesn't change the image for you. And I can tell you that all of TV nowadays, they are IPS or VA, all the tablets, all the, of course, mobile phones, because you can turn them around and see the image clear from all the sides. But TN technology is still widely used for a monitor application, because monitor usually is in front of you, and most of the time you look on it straight, or you look it from up or left or right side, but you very rare look on the monitor from the bottom side, yes? So on the bottom side in a TN monitor, we can place the grayscale inversion viewing angle, and still it's very practical to do because we don't look on the monitor from this side, yes? So this technology can be cheap, but also have some advantages for the gamers, because it's very fast technology, yes? So you can still use it, and it's still popular. And beside the liquid crystal inside, different organization of the liquid crystal in a VA and IPS, we also organize the subpixels a little bit different. So when we look on the TN, the simplest TN display, we will just see the subpixels, yes, with the color filters that we talked already about that. But if we would see the VA or IPS displays, most displays, they will have like subpixels of the subpixels, yes? So it's even more complicated. And then we have the subpixels divided into the smaller parts, where we put different organizations of the liquid crystals inside. And in this way, we can achieve even wider viewing angles and even better colors for the user. But of course, it's more complicated and more expensive to do. Okay, so short summary of the IPS and TN display, or IPS or VA technologies. So you can see here on the small image, and we have the TN display here, and you see the grayscale inversion. So when you are moving as a viewer of different angles, the image is not very clear anymore, yes, to you know, in basic words. But for IPS or VA technology, the effect will be the same. From all the sides, we see image very well, yes. So these are technologies that are popular where we need wide viewing angles, and TN is popular where we don't need, as I mentioned already, for example in monitors. So here we have few advantages of IPS. So they are very accurate with the colors, and of course we have the wide viewing angles. What is also important and practical in our projects is that the IPS is less sustainable to the mechanical force, yes, on the screen. And when we put the mechanical force on the screen, when we have a touch screen optically bonded, yes, so when we touch the touch screen, we push actually the display as well, and we squeeze the cells with this mechanical force. And when we have a TN display, every squeeze of the cell changes the image suddenly, with the IPS, because we have in-plane switching different crystals organization, this effect is lower, yes? It's not completely removed, but it's way lower. That's why IPS are very popular for you know, smartphones, tablets, etc., when we have the touchscreens usually optically bonded. Disadvantages, I put the question mark here because some of them are true, some of them not. It really depends on the real case, yes? What kind of display, what kind of IPS technology is there? So sometimes they can be more power consumption, in many cases not. They can be more expensive, but not necessarily need to be. So the new IPS panels can cost similar to TN panels, but for sure IPS panels basically have a longer response time, but again, it's not the rule. You can make IPS panels that are very fast and even faster than TN panels, but if you want the fastest possible display, probably the TN panel will be the fastest. That's why I mentioned before that the TN technology is still popular in the gaming market. Because usually we are in front of our monitor straight, so we don't care about viewing angles that much, but we care how fast the display is. Yes, so the TN can be very fast, and of course you can find a lot about this in the internet, a lot of discussions which technology is better. It really depends what you want to achieve. Okay, so now we will jump into the backlight.